Hi, Rebecca Simmering. We're here in the yard of Rebecca Simmering, an artist in Pawtucket and Providence. And some of her works are behind her and next to her, which are they're sort of these outfits. Can you explain what they are?
Sure. About over a decade ago, I'm really into collecting ephemera and paper. And I started taking these walks home from work about a mile from here, and I kept picking up lottery tickets everywhere I went. They just looked so beautiful and colorful, and I kept thinking about what was the person thinking who threw them away. They were all tickets that were losers, mostly. Some of them were winners, actually, for $1 or $2, so that was kind of funny that wasn't enough money to win, so it got kind of chucked in the wind. But I was very attracted to the color and thinking about what it meant to try for that luck, to try for that dream. And so I collected enough of them, and I started thinking just sort of about suits. I started thinking about something that you could kind of transform yourself almost into something more magical and interesting and, you know, exciting. So, and I liked them. I started thinking a lot about connecting them together so they'd make sound. And I'm really interested in a lot of historical textiles around the world, and when you're trying to change your luck or promote good luck in your life, a lot of textiles have these long strings on them, or these pieces that make sound to sort of drive away evil or to whisk away the bad luck or bring the good luck in. So a lot of my work has lots of pieces to it, and I started to think what would be the best thread to use for it, and I thought something, you know, at the drugstore where you buy them, the lottery tickets originally. So I picked up some wax dental floss, which was really easy to sew them on. So they're all individual pieces that are sewed on with the dental floss. And they have these long strings, sort of to exemplify what I've been looking in historical textiles, like the long strings, like to let the bad luck, you know, move away from you.
So that's something you studied?
It's something that I studied. Something I find really of interest to me.
I like the contrast of it, the magical aspect to it, to this kind of very USA accessible items that you find.
Well, one of the things I thought, the power suit is a very, you know, iconic thing in the US about being the man, you know, being the person in power in a way.
Or the woman.
Or the woman too, and the woman too. And the woman too, but you know, it's sort of been the man for a long time, or you know, just this position of power, and just thinking about sort of that image of the suit, and how do you transform that suit into something that you want. Some of them, actually, when I'm done with them, they look a little more feminine too, mm-hmm. when I'm done with them. And
so you have a suit there that looks like, I said, David Bowie would have worn
it. Yeah.
And then there's one for a baby.
Yeah.
And then below there's another art piece, but
that's off handmade paper from lottery tickets. But I could talk about the one in the back first. Mm-hmm. Some of my original suits, they didn't have this look of like American-made sort of things. This one actually is called American-made because I was actually thinking about the flag in the moment. There was an election, like, you know, 3 years ago, a presidential election, and just so much flag waving, so much, you know, patriotism. And it felt so lopsided who thought they were patriots in a way. I start thinking back, because I sew a lot, and it's sort of like what Betsy Ross did in the beginning. You know, you kind of make your own life. You make your own magic, in a way, in your life. And so I start thinking, well, you know, I own the flag, too. Everybody owns the flag. It's not one political party or anything. So I started making lots of flags. And I made little ones and larger ones with some of these lottery tickets that I was finding, thinking about the lottery itself. I mean, this is the most democratic thing you can do to earn money. I mean, everybody has a chance. Everybody. It's not something you have to earn and to try for. I mean, everybody does it. So I started thinking about that too, making these flags. And then I sort of transposed that onto the suits, thinking about, you know, historical, you know, political fashions too. So I have a few suits like that. And so that one's called American Made from that time. And this one I made a few years ago. I was at a residency in Tennessee called at the Aramont School of Crafts. And I actually picked up some Tennessee bedding slips. And these are all hand fringed with there's a type of scissors that they use to make pinatas.
What's betting slips?
Betting slips are like the things you put on, they're the, like for Powerball, Mega Millions.
Oh, for betting.
For betting. Yeah, betting slips. And so they're really long and thin, and so a lot of times I'll collect them from, you know, betting parlors and things like that. Some, most of them are used.
Where people bet.
Where people bet. Where people bet. And so I hand fringe them and sewed them on the little tufts. And the same thing with the lottery tickets. At the time it was winter when I went, and I was thinking a lot about how paper is also used as sort of a something of warmth, especially in poverty. We sort of you roll it up. Sometimes, and like in my old house that I live in, it's over 100 years old. When we renovated it, they had paper with it on the floorboards to make it warmer in the house.
Wow.
And so paper can, it's interesting, it's such a fragile thing in a way, and an ephemeral thing. Yeah, it can give you warmth and comfort too, like birds put in their nests too, same thing.
True.
Yeah, they do. So I was thinking about that with this piece and making it really tiny. And this is actually a tiny little suit that could fit a tiny little baby too. It's actually handmade.
Or a bird.
And I've actually had birds, and I've worked outside, take the dental floss, and they have like a vest where they have the dental floss in it, which is really funny. So this is also sort of a like a good luck sort of little cloak. I had this funny experience last year when I'd never found a four-leaf clover ever. My grandmother always found four-leaf clovers, like the little clovers on the ground that you find.
So those are made of lottery tickets?
Yeah, so I made paper out of the lottery tickets and some of these betting slips, and I made this really thin paper that I hand cut, and so there's one little four-leaf clover in here. It's about wishing for that.
But you have sold some of your pieces in Spain and other places.
I have, just some smaller pieces through Etsy years ago. Fidelity Investments owns my work. They own a few pieces. They like my work.
Oh, wow.
They saw it, so they owned a large suit. It's in their green building in Smithfield,
Smithfield,
Rhode Island, and a pair of gloves that I made, too, with lottery tickets. So. And some, you know, personal collectors, too.
Very good. And what are your plans in the future with this?
Well, you know, I'd like to do, I'm actually making a lot more handmade paper. I'm transforming things that I find into paper, and then doing some printmaking with that as well, and sewing with it, and just trying to connect with other artists. And
yeah, and that's why I'm doing these interviews, so that you can connect with other artists and patrons and buyers,
yeah.
And so they know who you are and a little bit about your personality and what you're doing. So, thanks, Rebecca.
Thank you.
See you later.
Nice to chat with you today.